This is Duke University.
Duke biochemistry professor Paul Modrich was out of town the morning he learned he won the Nobel Prize in Chemistry, but there was a lot of celebrating happening inside his lab on campus.
It started bubbly and shaky and excited for him, and I wanted to call him, but I figured he's on vacation, so leave him alone.
I'm so excited. This morning I get up, so I check the web. Oh, bro, got Nobel. I told my wife, oh yeah!
Modrich's postdoc students in the chairs of biochemistry and cell biology departments say the honor is well deserved. Modrich, along with Tomas Lindahl of the Francis Crick Institute and Clare Hall Laboratory in the UK, and Aziz Sancar of UNC Chapel Hill, won the Nobel Prize in Chemistry for having mapped at a molecular level how cells repair damaged DNA and safeguard the genetic information.
What Paul's done is shown a basic fundamental process that occurs and that is critical to life.
That is important in protecting ourselves from cancer and making people who have these mutations at risk for cancer.
Hogan added that the teamwork between Duke and neighboring UNC highlights the importance of collaboration.
Together, these two institutions bring a lot of recognition to the whole area of North Carolina, which really needs more education in science and more visibility for this kind of work.
Colleagues and students admire the way Modrich conducts his own lab research.
Every time when I come in the morning or go at night, this Paul is here in the lab.
He loves to do bench work, always make time to do work himself, not just delegate. And he loves to share his knowledge, ask him any question, and he loves to give you the backstory on how it was discovered.
Colleagues also note that Modrich serves as a wonderful role model for students.
He's humble. You could just never think of someone who deserves a prize more recognition than Paul Modrich.
Reporting for Duke University, I'm Julie Schoonmaker.
Produced by Duke University.